students. This is Dr. Sharath Babu, a mathematics faculty, to teach second and higher order differential equations. It is a unit which is in mathematics 2. Unit number 3 is very important. From this unit, we can expect minimum 15 marks, very easiest unit. So only thing is what? To write the solution of the nth order differential equation. What is an nth order differential equation? A differential equation contains the highest derivative n. That is, the differential equation is of the form d power n y by dx power n plus p1x into d power n minus 1 y by dx power n minus 1 plus p2x d power n minus 2 y by dx power n minus 2 plus like so on pny pnx into y is equal to q of x, where p1, p2 likes on pn are functions of x or sometimes constants. If they are constants, it is called a nth order differential equation with constant coefficients. Otherwise, it is called a nth order differential equation with variable coefficients. The q of x term is non-zero. If it is a continuous function, then it is called non-homogeneous linear differential equation of nth order. If q of x is equal to 0, it becomes homogeneous. Whenever it is homogeneous, we have to calculate only the complementary function of this differential equation. Or if q of x is non-zero, then we have to calculate the complementary function as well as the particular integral. The particular integral will come when q of x is non-zero. That should be continuous in the specified domain. Now, let us discuss how to calculate the complementary function first. For the same differential equation, suppose q of x is equal to 0, then it is called a homogeneous differential equation. It is a homogeneous differential equation. Introduce the differential operator notation. The notation for our convenience only. Operator form d is equal to d by dx, d square is equal to d square by dx square. While doing the problem, see how to do like this. D power n is equal to d power n by dx power n. What is dy? It is dy by dx. D square y is equal to d square y by dx square, etc. D power n y is equal to d power n y by dx power n. 1 by d is a inverse operator that we will discuss after some time. So how to get the general solution of a homogeneous differential equation? F of d is operating on y, which is equals to 0. Here, f of d, the operator form, actually the differential equation is transformed into the operator form. D power n, p1 d power n minus 1 plus p2 d power n minus 2 plus like so on pn minus 1 into pn is a expression. It becomes a polynomial. It becomes a polynomial by equating it to 0. Wherever d is there, replace m and equate it to 0 to get the auxiliary equation. What is auxiliary equation? It is a supportive equation to get the complementary function of the given differential equation. This auxiliary equation can be obtained by replacing d with m and equate it to 0. And see, the auxiliary equation f of m is equal to 0 is a nth degree polynomial. Every nth degree polynomial possesses n roots. Name them m1, m2, x0, mn. The roots may be having different nature. Depending on the nature of the roots, you write the complementary function as mentioned here. If all the roots are realigned distinct, then the complementary function is c1 e power m1x, c2 e power m2x, cn e power mnx, realigned distinct, realigned different also, some of the exponential functions. If two roots are equal, say m1 is equal to m2 and the remaining roots are realigned distinct, then the complementary function is c1 plus c2x into e power m1x, x is missed here, c1 plus c2x e power m1x plus the remaining roots are realigned distinct, c3 e power m3x plus like so on, cn e power mnx. Two roots are equal. If three roots are equal, the complementary function is the roots are real and three roots are equal, the remaining roots are realigned distinct. C1 plus C2x plus C3x square into e power m3x plus like so on sum of the exponential functions. It's a mixed case of 3. Third one. And the fourth one, the roots are complex numbers, say alpha plus I beta. Alpha plus I beta. There is a principle in algebraic equations. If alpha plus I beta is a root, then automatically its complex conjugate alpha minus I beta is also a root of the equation, that algebraic equation. So whenever alpha plus I beta is a root, the complementary function is e power alpha x into c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x. We are obtaining the root from the auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is obtained from the operator f of d. F of d is equated to 0 and writing d is equal to m, that we have discussed earlier. If three roots are repeated twice, alpha plus I beta, alpha plus I beta, here missed it, is repeated twice, then complementary function is e power alpha x into c1 plus c2x into cos beta x plus c3 plus c4x into sin beta x. This is about the fourth order differential equation, because every nth order differential equation contains n arbitrary constants. Up to it is fourth order, four arbitrary constants. If it is an nth order, the remaining roots are real and distinct. C5 e power m5x plus like so on plus cn e power mnx, like that. If three complex roots are repeated, it is a very rare case for a sixth order differential equation. E power alpha x into c1 plus c2x plus c3x square into cos beta x plus c4 plus c5x plus c6x square into sin beta x. This is the loop for repeated roots. This is for complex roots. It's a mixed case. Repeated complex. Repeated and complex. So, see an example how to get the complementary function of a differential equation. The third order linear differential equation. Why it is linear? The dependent variable y and their derivatives are in the first degree and they should not come in the product. It is called a linear differential equation. So what is the operator form? D cube by dx cube is capital D cube, d by dx is capital D, and plus 2 the constant, plus 2 the constant term is there. So operator form d cube minus 3d plus 2 is operating on y is equal to 0, and select the operator d cube minus 3d plus 2. So m cube minus 3m plus 2y into y is equal to 0. Wherever d is there, replace m. So you will get the auxiliary equation m cube minus 3m plus 2 is equal to 0. Remove y. Y is printed extra. F of m is equal to 0. That is, wherever d is there, replace m. M cube minus 3m plus 2 is equal to 0. The third degree polynomial, get the roots with your scientific calculator or trial and error method. The roots are 1, 1, -2. Two roots are real and equal, and another root is real. All are real, but among them two roots are real and equal. Equal real roots. So that the complementary function template is what? C1 plus C2x, x is there, C1 plus C2x into e power x. Plus the next root is minus 2 is real, C3 e power minus 2x. In example number 2 is a fourth order differential equation. See, it is directly given in the operator form d power 4 minus 2d cube minus 3d square plus 4d plus 4 is operating on y, the dependent variable y, which is equals to 0. Write the auxiliary equation f of m is equal to 0. How to get the auxiliary equation? Wherever d is there, simply replace m and equate it to 0. F of m is equal to 0. M power 4 minus 2m cube minus 3m square plus 4m plus 4 is equal to 0. A fourth degree polynomial. So every fourth degree polynomial possesses four roots. The roots are minus 1, minus 1, 2, comma 2 by trial and error method or synthetic division or Horner's method or inspection method. You can get the roots. Once the roots are there, what are the roots? Basically, they are real roots. Among them, they are repeated. How many times they are repeated? Minus 1 is repeated twice. 2 is also repeated twice. So that according to the complementary function template or complementary function rule, y complementary function is c1 plus c2x into e power minus x plus c3 plus c4x into e power 2x. One can write c1 plus c2x into e power minus x, c3 C3 plus C4x into e power 2x. Merely C1, C2, C3, C4 are arbitrary constant. And you observe that it's a fourth order differential equation. It contains four arbitrary constants. Like that, we can write the complementary function easily. So, whenever any boundary conditions are given, initial conditions are given in a differential equation, y of 0 is equal to minus 4, y dash 0 is equal to 14, this is example 4, first write the complementary function, and after obtaining the complementary function 1, impose the condition y of 0 is equal to minus 4. What is the meaning of this? At x is equal to 0, y is equal to minus 4. Substitute in the equation. Here I am assuming that x being the independent variable. And y dash 0 is equal to 14. What is this? Dy by dx at x is equal to 0 is 14. Y is there. Differentiate y one time dy by dx. Then dy by dx is equal to 14 and simultaneously put x is equal to 0. Two conditions, two equations we will get. Because it is a second order differential equation, it must need two conditions in order to get the arbitrary constant values numerically. So that numerical values are C1 is equal to minus 4, C2 is equal to 2. Like that, we can get the particular solution whenever the initial conditions are given. What is, why it is called an initial condition? The conditions are given at the initial stage, x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 or time t is equal to 0 level they are given. It is called a initial value problem. Similarly, some of the examples to get the complementary function. So, complementary function, first what is required? We have to write the auxiliary equation, and auxiliary equation roots nature. Roots are realigned different. Roots are repeated. Roots are complex roots. Roots are repeated complex. Like that, four cases we are discussed. In the next class, how to calculate the particular integral. The particular integral is existing when the right side is non-zero. That we will discuss in the next class. Thank you, students.